Natoli Engineering produced this instructional video to teach tooling installation and press setup in a rotary tablet press. This video will also detail how to set up the press in a thorough step-by-step approach. Now we will demonstrate how to load multi-tip tooling. Multi-tip tooling is a little more challenging to load because the punch and die bore have to line up precisely. The first step is to clean the guides using a punch guide brush.
We take the punch guide brush through the punch guides to clean all debris and dirt out of there. This allows your lubrication to stay clean and allows for a cleaner running press. After we clean the punch guides, we take a die seat cleaner, insert it into the die pocket, rotate it around to remove any debris out of the bottom of the die pocket. This allows your die to sit flush in the pocket, flush with the turret.
Next, take the die seat cleaner and rotate it clockwise while applying constant downward pressure to thoroughly clean the die pocket. Next, take a wrench and remove the upper punch takeout plate.
Next, we take the die insertion ring, we insert the die into it, center it over the die pocket in the turret.
Because this is multi-tip tooling, you need to be certain the punch and die are aligned perfectly.
Use the upper punch to align the die with the upper punch being keyed, and you use a clockwise force, forcing the key to preload the punch.
When the punch tips are inserted into the die bore, you will know it is completely aligned.
Next, we'll take the die driving rod and use it to tap the die into the die pocket.
And just to be certain it's seated properly, take the die insertion ring or a spare die and run it over the turret to make sure the die is flush with the die table. Then take an upper punch, rotate slightly clockwise while applying pressure to check alignment again. If you hear a clicking sound, that means there is misalignment between the punch and die. The goal is to have the punch tip enter the die bore smoothly. A minimal amount of contact is acceptable. If there is misalignment, remove the die and reseat.
Next, we will take the die lock screw and insert it into the die lock hole. I screw it in until it comes in contact with the die.
First, hand tighten, and then two clicks of the torque wrench are all that's needed to secure the screw.
Next, we take the die driving rod, insert it into the lower punch guide, tap up on the bottom of the die to make sure that the die lock screw is holding the die down properly. After tapping on the bottom of the die, you take your die insertion ring again and rub it across the top of the die table to verify that the die did not come out.
Next, recheck alignment with the upper punch. The next step, install the lower punch. First, take the barrel lube, shake the bottle, and use one spray onto the barrel of the punch. Then use the compression tooling grease on the punch head.
Take an acid brush, dip it in the food grade grease, and put a nice film of grease on the head. Cover the head, the outside diameter of the head, and the back angle.
Pay careful attention not to get the grease on the punch barrel.
Insert the lower punch into the lower guide, being very careful to hit your alignment. You might have to rotate the punch to get your alignment. After the lower punch is installed, it's time to set the punch retainer in place. Now you tighten the punch retainer up until the punch will stay in its place under its own weight.
The purpose of the punch retainer is to keep the punch from dropping during operation. If the punch retainer is too tight, it can damage the turret, cams, and tooling.
After you have the punch retainer set, the MP500 has a lower takeout cam that needs to be put into place.
Once it is installed, then recheck your punch heights to be certain your punches are not protruding above the die table. Next, check and be certain the anti-flight rail on the lower takeout cam does not allow for much movement.
You don't want to pinch the head, but you also do not want the punch too high up out of the die.
Next, reinstall the upper punch takeout plate. Next step, install the upper punch. Use the punch barrel lube and compression tooling grease. Just like the lower punch, use one spray of barrel lube and distribute evenly.
You apply the grease to the head on the upper the same as it is on the lower. Cover the head with a film, the outside diameter of the head, and the back angle. Again, paying careful attention not to get the grease on the barrel.
Then install the upper punch into the punch guide.
Now that we have the upper punch installed, we're certain we have alignment because we've checked it twice and the upper punches are key. You can move on to the next station. Today we showed you how to install tooling one station at a time. Generally, when you install tooling, you install all your dies, torque them down, all your lower punches, and then all your upper punches.
With practice, it can take approximately 3 to 4 hours to load a set of multi-tip tooling. Contact Natoli Engineering in the U.S. at 636-926-8900 or email np500techsupport@natoli.com.